Hey everyone, I haven't done an airplane video in a while. I wanted to do one this weekend. I had some time and I picked up the Great Planes Escapade sport flyer from Tower Hobbies. So this is an excellent second airplane or someone who wants to get into sport. It's not very big of an airplane. I believe it's only at 50 inches or so, and we have an OS 46AX going in there. We're going to take you from beginning to end, from the unboxing, all the accessories, parts you're going to need, to putting it together, to actually taking out on the field and flying it. So stick with us. We'll be back with the Great Planes Escapade. Okay guys, so here it is, the Great Planes Escapade. This is a really nice looking plane, and it's really affordable. Probably a very good second airplane in your fleet. You can get them from Tower Hobbies, and what I'm going to do now is just show you all of the components that are needed to put this plane together. So this should be all of them. I'm sure there's a couple that I've missed, but I just wanted to give you a list with pricing of actually, so we can show you exactly what the total cost of this airplane is with all the components and all the parts. So I went with their Tower Hobbies package, which gave me the Great Planes Escapade and this OS. It's a 46AX engine. I definitely had to get the optional cowling. So smaller components. So there's the glow plug right there. That's an OS number 8. There's our CA glue and our 30-minute epoxy. 5 servos, because I'm choosing to go with the servo for each aileron. So we need 5 total. These are the high-tech HS325 HBs. Ball bearing, carbonite gear. Hopefully this will work for me here. This is a new tail wheel. As we go down further, I'll show you the new tail wheel bracket that I purchased for it. Again, reading an rcuniverse.com, you can see where there are things that are needed for this airplane that you definitely should do, and I thought after reading that this is this is one of them. You're going to need a receiver and a receiver battery. So this is your regular Spectrum AR6200 and a 1600 milliamp receiver battery for it. Right there to the left is the fuel filter, and on the right side is the Great Planes mounting set that has the charger and the power switch built into it. So this is the first time I'm using that, and we'll have to see how that goes. You're going to need some hosing, some rubber hosing for your fuel line. Right here is the Sullivan tailwheel bracket that I'm going to put on the back of it. So this is a recommended item based off of that forum online. This is an exhaust deflector. I don't know if you guys have ever used these Dubro exhaust deflectors before, but they work really well to keep the oil and junk off your airplane. A lot easier to clean up. That is an 11.6 APC prop. We have 2 6-inch servo extensions, and those are for the aileron servos. And I bought some of this Dubro 3/8 inch diameter heat shrink tubing, and this is to heat shrink the connectors from the 6-inch extensions to the servos, so that's going to hold them all together. So all that stuff for the total price of... All right, guys, so that's it for the parts. I'm going to just unbox the box. I'm going to take all these parts aside, and I'm going to pull out the parts here, and we're going to see what's inside and see the quality of the items actually in the box. Okay, guys, I know unboxings aren't really exciting, so I'm going to do this kind of quick. We're just going to see what's in the box here and take it out to kind of look at. So right here we have the stickers and the manual there. Right here, first and foremost, is the elevator. Next is the rudder. And we have a... this is a wing. So one of the main wings. Here's another main wing. They said definitely make sure you check your control surfaces, all your hinges, to make sure that they're properly seated. I know some of them didn't get much glue, so you're going to want to check all that stuff. Right now, back in the box here. So here is the main fuselage for this airplane. What's kind of cool about the Escapade, although it is priced to sell, basically, it does come with its own pilot. Basically bolt-on tailwheel, or I'm sorry, the rudder and the elevator in the back are basically bolt-on, and the engine just pops in on front. So I feel that this is going to be a fairly easy plane to put together. Hopefully we'll have it done. I hear people do it within a few hours, so we're going to try for a few hours. There's the graphite rod that goes in the wings. We have our push rods here with the ends on it already, the clevises. We have a box of... these are the pants for the wheel pants. And a couple other bags here, gas tank and wheel. So we're going to get all this put aside. We're going to get the manual out. We're going to start at step one, and we're going to put this guy together.
Okay, guys, so we have the plane out on the table here. There were a couple things I did already I just wanted to go through. So in the fuselage area, it was suggested that I use some epoxy, and I epoxy a couple blocks down in here. This is the main wood piece that holds the bottom wing on. So the wing goes in here and then hooks into that little hole right there. So it was suggested that we use some epoxy in here to hold this whole piece together. So I epoxied that up last night. I also mounted the servos. I didn't exactly mount them, but I ran them through with the 6-inch extension. So I just need to screw these down, put the horns and the control arms and everything in there. And I decided that I'm going to actually epoxy my back, my rudder, my elevator down. So I cut the covering off from this area right here, so that there'll be a good match from this wood here. And I'm going to epoxy this down, and then epoxy the bottom here to the back of the plane. So to the back of the plane, I'm going to epoxy it right down and snug everything up. So that's what I'm up to next. I'm going to put a couple servos in the wings, epoxy the back end together, and we'll see what happens. Okay, guys, so we have the main wing put together here. I haven't epoxied the wings together yet, but I'm going to epoxy these together. I have the strap that holds the back end together. That's just in there, a rough end right there. It's not glued in. On the back side here, I have the servos mounted. I got the control arms, control surfaces all mounted and everything. So these, this wing is basically done. This main wing, I just need to epoxy the middle so that this wing is one piece. The next thing I'm going to work on here is epoxying the tail end to the fuselage area. So on the back of this airplane here, I'm going to actually epoxy the tail fin and the elevator in with this plane here, and then I'm going to tighten it down. So I just don't want it coming loose, so we're going to just get it epoxied in there and get the back end put together. This plane really is going together rather easily, like people have said. You know, one thing I do want to mention is they really do take care in their assembly process. So, you know, if you go to that RC Universe thread, you'll read that the hatch, the main canopy here, is does sometimes fall off because the magnets aren't strong enough. And they've corrected that with an addendum to the manual that says they've included a couple pieces of sticky pad, single-sided foam tape, that goes in the front here that keeps this pushing against it so that this stays in tight and there aren't it doesn't come loose. So, you know, you got to give it to Great Planes to recognize when there's problems and fix them. So I'm going to go ahead and epoxy all this in, and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, guys, we've made some progress here with the Escapade. I did epoxy on the whole tail section, the elevator and the rudder. I did also purchase a Sullivan tail wheel bracket that I'm going to mount underneath. I hear these work much better, so I'm going to mount this in back. That'll be my tail wheel. I mounted the front wheels, so those are all in there. I epoxied the main wing together. I put the servos on the main wing. Basically, what's left to do is I need to run the control rods back, push rods back to these devices in the back here, these control surfaces, the elevator and the rudder, and I need to install the servos for that. But we're coming along good here. Really, the next thing is putting the engine in, getting the gas tank in, and mounting this all up. These both side wooden pieces here have to be cut off. Right there, and to allow for the cowling to fit over the top. So this cowling here is just going to go over the top there, and it's just going to make it look real sporty and nice. I like the lines of this plane. It's going together easily, not many problems, and it looks really nice. So we're going to continue some more. Okay, so we're putting some more time into the Escapade today. Let me just show you how far I've gotten. Pretty much the rudder and the elevator assembly are all put together and epoxied in. I've run the push rods up to the front, and I'm now mounting the servos for the elevator and the rudder. I also mounted on the bottom here a Sullivan, I think it's a 5-pound tail wheel assembly, and I connected it to the rudder here using this this spring here underneath. There's not much more left to do. It was a relatively easy build. You can see the inside of it there. I basically have to cut the front wooden cowling off to accommodate the upgraded fiberglass cowling. So I still need to do that. I still need to mount the engine. But this model seems to be going together pretty well. Now that I've done them a couple times, I'm kind of getting used to what they need and how to do things, which is always difficult when you're first starting off building these kind of planes. So that's really about it for now. I'll give you an update in just a little bit. I want to get some more done on this today, and hopefully I'll have some more to show you. So sit back and relax, and we'll be back in just a minute. Okay, guys, so I wanted to give you an update on the Escapade. We're pretty much done. We don't have too much to go. So a quick look at it. It's pretty much done. All the control surfaces work. I added this switch in the side. So this is a switch charger unit here. This is a Dubro. You pull it to turn it on and push it to turn it off. And then it has a charger port right there where you could charge it up. So in one little location there, you could have both your on-off switch and your charger port. All of the landing gear is put on, the wheels, the wheel pants. Let me show you a little bit inside of it here. So I had to make a little modification because I installed this switch. It was up a little too far this way, and it interfered with the gas tank here, making the gas tank come forward a little more, which I bet is going to throw my center of gravity off. But so this tank can't go back as far as it wants to because the switch is in the way over here. So it's going to be fine. I don't think it'll be a problem, but the problem I did have was with the canopy right here, basically on the underside, if we look, the wood was straight flat all the way across here. And I Dremeled out that much of it right there, so that way when it went in, It didn't hit the gas tank here and was able to go in nice and smooth and then back and locks right into place, so there's nothing wrong up with it. It holds good, there's no problems there. So again, everything's working. Oh, the other problem I'm having is the battery. So this battery here is a 1600 milliamp NiCad. I think it's a, no, it's not a NiCad, it's a nickel metal hydride. Anyway, these are kind of big, these cells. They're kind of thicker. So what I wanted to do was I wanted to put the, I said, well, I'll just take the battery here and I'll put a piece of Velcro on the bottom of the canopy and I'll stick it to it like that. And then when I put it on, it'll all go together, which actually it does. That does work. But the problem that I'm thinking here is that, I don't know if you've read in that rcuniverse thread, it does say that there are some people who lost their canopies. And if I were to lose this canopy and this go flying off, then all of a sudden I lose control of my aircraft because I can no longer control it with no receiver battery. So I decided to take the battery then, and I could put it, well, I could just kind of Velcro it on top of the tank. But the problem with that, again, is that this front piece here has a place here where it has to kind of snap in. It just doesn't fit right there. So what I'm going to do is look for a different battery pack here, a flat one, maybe one that used the double A's. The standard flatter ones I bet would work just fine, so I'm going to get one of those. The next things are really just hooking up the, I put the throttle servo in here, and I got to hook up the throttle linkage. Once I hook up this throttle linkage here, I could connect the engine. The engine is just sitting there right now, but I can, I want to get that physically connected, screwed on, so there aren't any problems. And then the last thing I really need to do and focus on once it's all done and the engine's on and everything's connected, which is very close from now, I have much more left, is cutting out this cowling here. And this cowling is going to be a real pain to do. I did one on my Pulse 60. I wasn't really happy with it. I think I just made a really big hole right here for it and put it on. I wasn't really pleased with the look. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to, I think, cut it from the bottom. So on the bottom side here, do a cut all the way to there. So this kind of clamshells it and you can open it up like that. And then I want to open it up and I want to kind of center or figure out where, let's say, the center, the glow plug is on the engine there, and I want to mark it in here. And then I want to drill a hole or get a hole going right in this general area here and put it on and test it and take it off. And what I'd like to do is to have a nice tight ring around this engine here. I also want to show you on this engine, it's an OS 46AX. And I've opted to mount the lean rich screw right here. I'm not sure what that word is. I'm trying to think of the technical term, but the screw here that sets how lean or rich the engine runs. Anyway, this engine here, you can mount it straight up like it is right here. So you see it mounted straight up. So what that's going to allow me to do is cut a nice tight hole around here, against the engine here. So I think I want to try for a real nice tight fit on this cowling here with this engine. I want to get a nice good look. I only worry about like the exhaust, because when you put the exhaust on, that really kicks it out quite a bit right there. So if you think in terms of here, I'm gonna have to make a decent size cut in the side there. I've also thought about extenders. So extenders that go from here to the exhaust, you know, let's bring the exhaust out a little bit. What do you guys think about those? Are those possible? Have you used them? I'm not sure. Anyway, that's about it for now. I just have to mount the engine control linkages, and cut out the cowling. It's pretty much ready to go, so it really wasn't a difficult build. I'm not done yet, but...
So, everybody,
the Escapade is pretty much all together. I just wanted to kind of show it to you. So we have the engine in. This is the OS46AX. We did do, completed the whole assembly. I did put a, give you a look, the gas tank's in front. I put the receiver battery under the receiver. A little switch here on the side with the power and the charging jack. All the servos are mounted. The only thing I haven't done yet is balanced the prop and checked for CG. So pretty much everything is done. I've installed the fuel tubing. I installed my quick fill, my filter, and really the only thing left is the optional cowling. So I have my cowling here, and this is the cowling that I'm going to use. Okay, and this goes right on the front here like so. This is optional. I had to cut the two slats of wood off of each side to make room for this. So this is one of the hardest things left to do. It is all done, ready to break in the engine and ready to fly, but what I had to do was make this little template here, and this is a cardboard template. What I did was I just kind of put it over the front of the motor like so, and I kind of folded it over, and I cut out the hole exactly where I want it, and I did choose to use the rich lean, the adjustment idler right there. I chose to have it point straight up in the air so that I don't have to drill a hole in the side of the cowling. I could just have a bigger hole here in the top like I have right there. Anyway, I got this kind of cut out the way I wanted to, and then basically what I did was take the cowling here and insert this template into the cowling, and I'll try to get up close so you can see, and in the cowling here, and then I took a marker and I marked around the hole, so when I pulled this out I ended up inside the cowling of having the exact template, the holes that I want, that should hopefully line up with the engine when I'm done with it. So really the last thing left to do is to cut this. Now I decided to go, I'm going to do a bottom cut and cut the bottom half of this cowling, and then kind of pull it apart, clamshell it, and drop it on top like so, hook the exhaust in, and then I should be all set. So I'm going to do this now. When I come back, we'll finish up with this Escapade build. It'll be 100% done. And then we'll give you final costs of how much everything is, and hopefully have a flight demo coming soon. So thanks you guys for watching, and we'll be back in a little bit. Thanks, bye. Okay guys, so we're pretty much done here. What we have left to do is basically to bolt on the front cowling. I did mount the quick fill connector on the side of the cowling here, and the engine is all mounted on the motor mount there. What I did use, I'm going to show you guys, are these 256 blind nuts on the inside of the where the wooden cowling was. And those are basically these right here. And if you've ever seen these before, you probably can't see it, but if you've ever seen these before, these go on the inside of the wood. And as you tighten down, it has little teeth on it, and it pulls it into the wood, so it makes it like a permanent type mount there. And then I just bought some regular screws here. These are the same size, the 256. They're like hex nuts or whatever they're called. And what we're going to do is just take this now, and we're going to wrap it right around the outside of the engine here. And I wanted to make this a really nice design where there was no, you could see no separation in the back. So we have the separations in the front here, and we're going to do our best to keep it kind of hidden. So at this point, I really just need to make sure all the hoses are all tucked up out of the way. And what I'm going to do is just tape with some blue tape the split here on the cowling. I'm going to tape it together, and I'm going to tape the seam so that it's more rigid. So I kind of like that right there. And now I'm just going to run a piece of blue tape. Now, what I'm going to do probably is come back with some white tape or some, white tape is going to cover up the split here really nicely, where you may not even be able to see it. So that's kind of how we're going to have the engine there. That's pretty much how it sits, actually. I was able to use the Dremel and cut the top piece out here. I did not calculate correctly originally with the hose or the tube that goes from the tank to the exhaust. So there wasn't a spot for it in the cowling here, and I had to create one. And also, you really want to kind of look out for the spacing in the front here. You know, you want to make sure that you're just sitting perfect. It's almost like, you know, if you've done it once or twice, you're really going to be good at it, but as a beginner, it's kind of challenging to get everything to line up correctly. So what I'm going to do right now is just kind of bolt this thing down here. I'm going to put the prop on, the nose cone on, the exhaust on, and it's
okay,
pretty
guys,
much
so we're 100% done with the Great Plains Escapade.
This was a little longer of a video than what I wanted to show, but it definitely demonstrated this plane, its build from beginning to end, and also the cost involved in building this plane. Like I said earlier, this is an excellent second airplane. It's a decent, smaller sport flyer airplane, and it went together really easy. Just follow the instructions. I did a couple extra things, nothing crazy. So everything's hooked up. We have the cowling on the front. On the side of the cowling, I have a Dugro quick gas connector right there. So I take the fuel line and I can just plug it right in here to the side of the cowling and fill my tank like that. And then on the other side, like I showed you earlier, is the Dugro, the switch, and the charging jack in one. I really kind of like that. So again, this plane is 100% done. It went together really easy. And I'm looking forward to getting in the sky. Right now it's really cold out where I'm at, so this may be something I need to break the engine in the spring or so. But in terms of completeness, this airplane is 100% complete. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you like my videos. I hope you keep watching. Definitely give me a thumbs up, and we'll talk to you guys again soon. Take care now.